Yep, I am breaking out the full fingers today because it is chilly this morning. It's like in the low 50s right now. You know, I just spent the time over an hour like washing and detailing this bike because it got pretty dirty last Wednesday. And I almost didn't want to take it today, but today was going to be my only day to ride. Because I've been sick the last 2 days. And that has sucked, but... Whoa, watch the water puddle. Now, I like to keep my stuff looking nice, so... Usually after I'm riding, I'll... detail it real quick, or... You know, wash off any bugs, because I don't want that... staying on my paint and eating my paint job on this brand new Sport Glide. So I want to start this vlog by saying thank you to all of you that have subscribed to me. We just hit 250 subscribers just a few days ago, and now as I'm filming this video, we're at 260, so thank you very much. Great channel growth in the last few weeks to the last month. I'm really happy with the way things are going. So to kind of let you in on what's been going on the last week, I had a Great Egret come through on his Route 66 trip, and we spent the day out riding, and we had a great time. And we actually got pretty lucky too, because that morning it looked like it was gonna pour. But we found that, you know, it didn't rain, which was good. And at the same time, we kind of got lucky because, you know, we kind of headed east toward Missouri to hit the Mississippi, and we rode up the Grafton River Road. And you're going to see that footage from that video on his channel pretty soon. He just posted up, like, his first video from his trip. And, you know, he's spending more time riding than he is, you know, stopping somewhere and editing. And he's just living it up, and... I know he's having a fantastic time. Heck, as I'm filming this video, just last night, he reached the halfway point of his trip. So that's awesome. He's been putting on some miles. No, but anyway, we had to stop in Edwardsville on our way back, which is about, I don't know, you know, 35, 40 minutes from Litchfield, where I work, where I met him at. And he was staying in a hotel there. And, you know, as we were making our way back down 66, back to Litchfield, we could just see rain clouds out east, and here's some footage here. And the shit of it is, what looked like is we had rain in front of us and to the left of us, so we thought we were trapped. But as you can see, like in that footage, there's like a little pocket right there where we actually ended up squeezing into all the way home. We got really lucky. But no, I had a good time. I hope he had as good a time as I did on that ride. Pretty good day. I hope the rest of his trip is a good and a safe one. So just to let you guys all know, I did sell my last t-shirt in my D-Cycle t-shirt batch, and I was able to see Gerald Brand from the Heidi Foundation over the weekend and donate all that money that we raised from those t-shirts to his charity. And he was very appreciative. He says thank you, and I say thank you as well. Now, I'm not sure I'm going to get another batch printed up so soon. The second one didn't sell real well, but you know, things could change. If the subscriber count keeps going up, maybe more people will be interested. We'll just have to see. And to kind of go over what I said in the last moto vlog, my family is participating in the Autism Speaks Walk in St. Louis on October 13th, and we are taking donations for our walk team for Autism Speaks. If you would like to help out, go to the link in the description below, and you could donate, you know, $25 or more. If you would like to donate less money, I know not everybody has 25 extra bucks to donate. If you want to mail something, leave me a comment. I'll find a way to private message you, and we can work that out. So any help, greatly appreciated. If you guys can't, don't worry about it. It's fine. So I'm pretty excited. Only a few work days left, and me and my wife are going on vacation next week. We are going to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. We have gone actually a handful of times before. And main reason is we're big Penguins fans, and we bought tickets to opening night. So we're really excited to attend an opening night game out there. And they're playing Washington, which is like one of the biggest hockey rivalries right now. So I'm really looking forward to that. And besides, Pittsburgh is a real fun city. And we've been there, like I said, a handful of times. And there's lots to do there. There's lots of places. It can be kind of touristy in spots. I think this time we're going to visit the Andy Warhol Museum. Maybe go up Mount Washington on the little trolley that they have out there. And there's some spots that we usually go to every time we go that we usually have a blast at. So really looking forward to that. Vacation's long overdue for both of us, I think. We're just ready to get away from from reality for about a week. Yeah, I'm glad I put on the full fingers, otherwise my hands would be freezing right now. It's been a while since I've worn these. You know, they're more safe than my fingerless gloves, but my fingerless gloves just have more function. But I know if I ever go down that, you know, I'm going to regret it. My fingertips especially. Yeah, I'll be looking forward to it when it's time to go home. It's going to be about 71 for the high today, and the ride home should be fantastic. I can't wait. So I hope all you guys have been enjoying the new Sport Glide videos. I was kind of worried for a little while that, you know, since I was getting rid of the iron, that, you know, some people wouldn't stick around. But thankfully, I mean, the channel has just grown. And I hope to do some more videos just regarding the Sport Glide, like maybe some how-tos and stuff, because when I looked on YouTube, there's nothing there. So, you know, if you have one of these bikes or you're thinking of owning one, I think maybe some how-tos would be beneficial for people that are looking for that information. Because I think soon I'm looking to put new grips on this bike. I've kind of been browsing around at aftermarket exhaust options as far as slip-ons. Cobra makes a really cool one that I was thinking about, but I really want to stay with Vance and Hines, but they don't have anything out yet, and I don't know if they even will. But I don't know if it's just going to be a waiting game or what, but, you know, I only want this bike to be as quiet as it is for so long. So that's all I got for this video, guys. Thanks for sticking around. Thanks for watching the video. Please give this video a thumbs up. It helps out the channel tremendously. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're new here, and you hit that bell icon. That way you know when new videos are up and available for your eyes and your ear holes. You guys take it sleazy. I'll see you in the next one.